Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You may be confused by the title of the video, but I assure you, I truly believe that we do not need al-Bukhari. That we do not need al-Bukhari.
As say Bukhari is concerned, it is the most authentic book amongst all the books of Hadith, the highest level.
Wait. I'm not a zindiq, not a bulith, or trying to do something crazy like that, so don't worry about it. What I'm trying to say is if we all went to sleep, we all woke up in the morning and there was just no Sahih al-Bukhari, that would not affect us at the least.
We don't lie for the sake of our religion, astaghfirullah.
And the reason is because, alhamdulillah, everything that's in Sahih al-Bukhari can be found elsewhere. So you see this concept of 200 years after the Prophet, peace be upon him, passed away, there was a guy who lived in Uzbekistan, who was Persian, and he started to, who didn't even know Arabic, who started to write down hadiths and attribute them to the Prophet. That's garbage.
There is a general consensus amongst all the scholars of the Muslim Ummah from the time and until today so far, that the book of Al-Imam al-Bukhari, the collection of ahadith which Al-Imam al-Bukhari collected, is considered to be the most sound book after the Quran.
All right? Everything that he wrote, he took from his teachers, and everything that his teachers had, they took from their teachers, and so on and so forth, up until the Prophet, peace be upon him. And you can find these same reports in different books of hadith.
And you think, Abeo Chache, you haven't even explained anything.
Now, one thing I'd like to bring your attention to is a genre of hadith literature called the mustakhrajat, which pretty much provide the same hadiths that you find inside Bukhari, and of course in other works as well, like Sahih Muslim, Sunan Tirmidhi, and what they do is they narrate the exact same hadith, but they bypass al-Bukhari by going through their own teachers.
Crook! Wallahi, you're a crook! You are a crook! You are a crook!
So, for example, one of these is Mustakhraj Abi Nu'aym al-Isbahani ala Sahih al-Bukhari. This was like printed last year, alhamdulillah, beautiful book, and that's what Abu Nu'aym does. Similarly, another Abu Nu'aym, this one is Al-Haddad, who produced the exact same thing. However, his book was a combination of Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. We also have other works like Mustakhraj al-Bujairi, and Mustakhraj al-Milanji. Both are in manuscript form. If anyone wants to pick them up, work on these works, get them published, go ahead. Apparently no one's doing it.
The highest is Sahih Bukhari. And it's ijma amongst the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah scholars, among the Sunni scholars, that after the Book of Allah, after the Quran, the next in authenticity, the next to be followed is Sahih Bukhari. There's no doubt about it. The second most important book of Islam, it is Sahih Bukhari.
So yes, one more time, we do not need Sahih Bukhari.
Why doesn't he answer the question? I mean, I don't get what the, like, say something for God's sakes.
That we do not need al-Bukhari.
Listen to me. We have the evidences. You don't believe? Wallahi, we have the evidence. We saw it with our eyes. Don't mess around. Don't play our games.
That we do not need al-Bukhari.
We don't lie for the sake of our religion, astaghfirullah.
That we do not need al-Bukhari.
This is wrong.
That we do not need al-Bukhari.
In terms of hadith, this is why it is known as asahhul kutubi ba'da kitabillah. It is known as the most correct and authentic book after the book of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Is this guy handsome? Really? Nobody would call this creature handsome. I don't care how many shots you've had at the local pub last night. You cannot ever call that handsome. I don't care if you gave birth to that. You would not call that handsome.